las cosas como son. Vamos de fuego en fuego hipnotizándonos, y a cada paso sientes otro déjà vu. Oh no.
Hey, this is DJ Noah Michelle. I'm doing another review for you. Today it's going to be on a Rockville facade, and it's the white one, which is, I think it's really nice, and it really shows the lights and a lot better than the black one that they have. The scrims are interchangeable, and we'll discuss that in a little bit. Why don't we start unwrapping it? It's right here in front of me in this soft case, and then we'll go ahead and take a look at it. Here we go. First of all, this bag is very, very nice construction. The canvas and the zippers are really good duty. It looks like it's very well made. It looks like it's gonna last for years, which is very important. It's got some handles here, and you know, for people that carry a lot of their own equipment and maybe don't have a roadie or help, this is really nice because you can carry the facade in one hand and leave your hand free for another, or you can actually throw this over your shoulder, and you can actually carry this, you know, carry it with you. I mean, so you can carry that and then carry something else in this hand, and you have this other hand free, which is great. It's a great feature. I really like it. The facade fits snug in here, but not so snug that you can't close it up, or not so snug where you have a hard time taking it out. So it's a really nice bag, and just wanted to point that out. It's also padded in the bottom, which is really nice. So whenever you set it down or something, it doesn't hit hard, and you know, you might bend or break something. But I don't think you will that. It's very well built, and we'll get into it when you put this away. All right, so setting up the facade is really simple. These are very easy to open. You have no problem opening it up. And and I'll go ahead and add the dimensions. When I got it, it came with an assembly kit. The instructions were really rudimentary. I mean, they were very simplistic, and it's just one page. But it really isn't hard to put together, and if you're pretty handy, you shouldn't have any trouble at all putting it together. And it all just came with the brakes. It came with these brackets and stuff, and basically you just, you know, you just get them, you fit them in, and then you tighten them up, and that's it. It's really nice. Like I said, it's really sturdy. It says it's built out of aluminum, but then it's painted really nice. It has like a little gloss to it, like sheen, and it's really good. Now, I saw another review about, actually not the review, but somebody commenting that they had bought one and the Velcro was really cheap and it fell out. Well, I've had this for about, I want to say about 2.5 months now, 3 months now. And the Velcro, I mean, this is really good Velcro, and it works really well. And if the Velcro that you have on there is not working out for you, you can always go to Lowe's or Home Depot and buy yourself a tape of Velcro. And it's going to cost, you know, $15. And you know, for what you pay for this facade, which I'll get into in a little bit as well, you know, is well worth it, okay? So like I said, I mean, the construction is really good. You also have the option of buying two, and depending on how big your rig is, you can actually, you know, really expand and maybe add another tier to it. And again, for the price that you pay for this one, you know, you might be able to justify buying another one and just putting them all together. Depending on how much you want to cover and what you want to do and what effect you want to have. The scrim is really nice. I'm gonna set it up for you as well with some lights. I just want you to see it without any lights or anything right now, so you can take a look at it. If you see my other videos where I've done a gig vlog, you'll see it. You'll see the lights coming in. They they show very nice. A lot of people like the black one, and the black one, you know, a couple of years ago might have seemed elegant and just simplistic, but now people want a little bit more of glamour. They want a little bit more of pop, and you can't do that with the black one. You put lights through the black one, and it's almost like a mute point. It's just a backdrop, basically. So if it's in the back and everything is black, that's fine. But in front of you, you really want to pop. And a lot of equipment is in black, but it's also coming in white now. And a lot of people have two rigs. They have a black rig and they have a white rig. And depending on the venue that they're doing, that, you know, they can bring out, you know, whichever one. I really like the white facade. I think it really made everything pop. It covers up everything, you know, all the cables, your table, depending on what you're using. If you're using just a plain table, or like me, that I use a shelving system, just use it up to the tier. I mean, it sits perfect. It sits really perfect for me. I really like it. Again, I'll put in the specs, the height, the width of each panel. I mean, you have plenty. I put my subs in the back. I don't like putting my subs out in the front because people tend to want to sit down on them or stand on them to talk to me, or maybe even put their drinks on there, and that's a little bit frustrating. So you don't really want to do that. You want to protect your gear, and you also want to protect people from escaping. So that would probably be a good justification of getting two of these bad boys. They can turn either which way as well. You can get really creative. As you can see right here, you see, you can, I mean, these will turn. So you can make it really small as well. You don't have a lot of space where you're at. If you just want to kind of cocoon yourself in, if you want to do a V formation, you can do it as well. I mean, there's so many great options with this. And like I said, it's sturdy, stands up really well, very well built. I've had it for a few months, haven't had any problems. It doesn't snap, crackle, or pop, or make me cringe or anything when I'm closing it up. I feel very confident when I'm putting it away. I don't have to treat it, you know, with tweezers like it's a delicate thing. Me personally, I like having the panels in and the frame out, and I'll show you why. I actually think that looks nicer because it actually creates a frame around the scrims, and when the light hits, I mean, these scrims really light up, and it really distinguishes, you know, a frame, so you can see each panel with the light. So it looks really nice, and I'll go ahead and set that up for you, and I'm going to go ahead and just fast forward to that, and let me set the lights for you.
So there you go. Now you could really appreciate how the light shines through and what the facade does. And that's basically it. It's a great investment. It looks awesome. If you're starting to get into lighting and up lighting, which is, if you're not already doing it, then you're missing out. You're missing out on a good investment, because you can charge extra per par light. You can charge extra for, you know, for different accessories and additions that you have, either whether you have fog or you're using some type of effect, lighting effect. I mean, everything is extra, and it sets you apart. I definitely think this facade will set you apart. I think that this facade will really, really up your game and make you look more professional. And that's what you always want to do. You want to look professional, and you want to make sure that you're giving people a show, because when you're DJing, yes, you're playing the music, but then you also, you know, you want to set a show for the people. And once you start DMXing as well, I mean, all the different lights, the lasers, the strobes, everything comes through that facade. That facade is really just going to make everything pop. That's just two lights running straight up, and they give a great effect. I really like it. I've been very happy with it. I bought it from Rockville. They have an option for a black and white. You can also buy separate scrims, and you can get the black ones. And you know, if you want to use a white frame and maybe have a black scrim, you know, it'll look decent.
There's another video too, saying that the Rockville, it was shorter, it was smaller, it was cheap. It really isn't cheap. It's a really, really good unit. It works well. It's very sturdy. It doesn't look cheap. It doesn't feel cheap. It comes with a bag, which In my other videos, I've emphasized to make sure that when you buy equipment, if it comes with a bag, that's an extra value. That's a $60, $70, $80 value, you know, for a bag and stuff. But it looks really nice. I've gotten a lot of compliments on it. And, you know, paying $350 for a Novo or a American DJ one, you know, I went with the cheaper options. I love DJing, but, you know, I do it to supplement my income and help out my family, so I can't break the bank. I can't invest, you know, hundreds and hundreds of dollars. So I think this was $149, and it's a very good investment. It's a great deal. It's a good product. It's light too. The American DJ one is super heavy, and at the end of the night, you're tired. The last thing you want to do is carry a bunch of heavy things. Well, guys, that was my little review on this facade. I hope you guys liked it. A few of the selling points for me was that it covers up my bass speakers, because I don't like people sitting on them, setting stuff on them. So I always put it in the back. I think they look kind of tacky out in the front. Big enough to just about cover up my speaker stands. Now, I'll do a review on those scrims that I use for my speaker stands as well. I mean, they're a great, great addition to the rig that I'm using right now, and I'm really happy with it. That's a quality facade. It does not look cheap. It does not feel cheap. And the only thing cheap about it is the price. I think you'll be really happy with it. And as you saw with the lights, it looks beautiful. It sets up really nice. I think you'll really, really like it. And you won't be disappointed, okay? So again, this is a review on the Rockville facade in white. And I look forward to doing some more videos for you guys. I hope they're helping you. I hope you're getting gigs. I hope you guys are working. You guys are busy on the weekends and weekdays too. Okay, so again, this is DJ Noah Michelle. Thank you for watching my video. Please like and subscribe and leave a comment if you just want to say hi, or if you have any questions, or if you didn't like something and you'd like to see a little bit more or something, let me know. And I'll try to accommodate you. And,